Hello everybody, I'm Armando the animator. I'm using Spine to animate Tracer from Overwatch. This is the fourth video from the series and today I will be adding knee joint. This will be a short video. Before making any more animation, I want to add controller to this knee because this leg is in perspective, and if we want to make her squats, this leg behaves weirdly. So I decided to add knee joint that can give us ability to move her in perspective. Okay, let's get started. Along with the knee joint, I also want to cover a butt rig. When she bends, I want this part to go outwards to behave a little bit more naturally. Right now I have added two bones. You can see they are in the root. Here are they. And also bound them to avoid making this video too long. So what would I need to parent this bone to the this bone and make an IQ? For that I will give a target here. And the important thing that I need to parent this target to this bone. So when we move this bone, this will stretch and contract. Right now we see that it doesn't work. This means that we need to fix order in our constraints. Here you can select the constraint and click reset. It will do mostly fine, but if it doesn't, you need to manage yourself by moving around the order. So right now let's try and reset it. Yeah, it fixed the problem. So here you can see that it does stretch and contracts. Maybe we need to move a little bit here so it doesn't snap. Let's see how it works. Yeah, I'm happy that. Now let's go to the knee. What I want to achieve to keep IQ functionality of this leg, just add one bone here, which can control the leg in perspective, shortening these parts. Okay, for that, let's remove IQ constraint. We can see that the leg snapped to its original position. We don't want that. Let's select Ctrl Z and select this bone and hit Ctrl C. This way we copied bone transform, both of them. And after that we can delete the IQ, select these bones again and hit Ctrl V. This way we will remain at the original position. Okay, now let's select the upper leg bone and hit duplicate. It also will duplicate this bottom leg bone. And let's remove the images inside of them. And also the target bone. We don't want that. And see what we actually copied here. Yeah, we have exactly the same bone chain, which we will be using as a new IQ chain for the leg. For that, let's select both of them, let's color them red and create an IQ. You will be using same target and same name. Okay, let's see what we have. We have an IQ chain exactly working the same, but we separated deformed bones, the original bones that are bound to these meshes. So we will be attaching them to these bones with a different rule. Okay, next we will be selecting the parent bone of this upper leg bone, which will be the hip, and creating a bone near here. Anyway, I'm going to copy transforms. Let's copy from these bones. Let's change it to red and give some nice icon. Yeah, we have a bone that does nothing, just moves around. Now let's select bottom bone, deformed bone that controls the mesh, and parent it to this joint. And what we need to do next is select deformed bones and create an IQ chain, one bone IQ chain. For upper leg, I will select this joint and give it a name. Let's give it top IQ, and this will be the bottom IQ. Next, let's select both of them and enable compress and stretch for them. This way I will have a leg behaving a little bit weird. But if we do slight movements, this can make sense. Okay, now we need to merge those behaviors together. So the I key also moves, and we want to this be switchable. So if we want to have control, we have it. If not, it just behaves as previously would behave. So for that, I will select this joint and create the last constraint and select this bone, the bottom bone of the I key chain. Okay, let's give it a name and click match. Right now it doesn't do anything because it has exactly the same position, but when you click match, it saves, stores the difference between two bones. Okay, next let's give 100 value, percent value, to translate and see what we have. Okay, I think we have problems with the order. For that, again, we can select the constraints, hit reset, or do it manually by moving them around. I think spine will do it great here. Now we have exactly the same behavior as when we had when video started. Just we have one powerful bone here, which will do nothing here because it has fully controlled by the constraint. But when we need, even in animation, we can animate those values. We can reduce the values a little bit, not much, because if we reduce it at all, it will not be attached to the I key. And this way we can have both I key and control at the same time. Not too much, a little bit. I also see that we have a problem here. When then this bone is getting shortened, it scales and so this behaves weirdly. So we can solve it quickly. For that, let's select that bone. Let me find it. Maybe a little bit difficult. No, it was not. Let's create a bone here. It will create in the root position. Actually, I'm going to select that bone, copy transform, and of course, paste it here. Okay, now I need to bind also this bone and give those top vertices to be controlled fully by this bone. I think I will avoid that weird behavior. Okay, now let's see what we have. That will behave exactly the same because this bone also gets scaled when the parent is scaling. So for that, if we disable this functionality, inherit scale, we will have this remain unscaled even though it rotates. You can see it rotates exactly as parent does. But it's not scaling. So let's see the difference with scale inheritance without. Okay, let's see what we got. Yeah, this works as there is some kind of perspective, because originally this bone would be here and the leg would look weird. So we can control it here by moving it around and see what works best for us. Let's also see how she does squats. I think I can work with the numbers. Okay, that was it. I hope the next video will definitely be about making walk. So make sure you are subscribed, and if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. That was it. Thank you for watching.